I'm going to show you what you can do if your Elgato game capture card doesn't get detected by your PC and your OBS Studios. So it's quite easy to fix actually. First off, we want to make sure that it's connected the right way. So what you do is you want to look over here. So in the input, we have to connect our HDMI, and our HDMI has to go to our PC. So make sure it's good connected to our PC over here. Now, next to our input, we have another cable that we need, and that's the USB-C cable. And the USB-C cable has to be connected also with your PC. And all of these cables come with your Elgato, guys. Don't worry about that. So we only go to your PC over here. And what you want to do is you want to connect this USB-C like to your 3.0 port. And you're basically done. So now it's connected. Now you can just leave it wherever you want. I'm just gonna leave it over here. And now let's go over to our PC. Now, what we want to do on OBS Studios is we have actually two types of sources. Like you see, my game capture is enabled, but it doesn't show up. So let me remove this really quickly. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going back to add source. And on here, we have video capture device. On here, we can also use our Elgato. And we have our game capture. So, for example, if you want to record your desktop itself, you want to click on here. So, like you see, guys, we got our screen right now with our Elgato. So, you can also read it on here. Game capture, HD60S+. And if it's not selected, just select it from here. And now you can click on OK. Now what you want to do is just make this fit to the screen. So let's do that. Transform. And go to fit to screen over here. Now it's going to look like this. What we can do is we can make this a bit smaller. And we can move this to another place like here. And now it's actually recording here, like you see, guys. So what you can also do is, for example, you can close off OBS and we can open up OBS from here. And once you open it up and connect to our game capture card, it's going to actually record on this screen. So on this screen, if it's going to record, if you want it to be recorded at this screen, you just move your OBS Studios out of the way to your other screen and you can just record on here. So that's how you can do it. Now let me go to the other thing which you also can do, and that's also pretty cool. Let me delete this. Go to source. And if you are playing a game, for example, go to game capture. On game capture, you want to go over to OK. And now, like it says on here, capture any full screen application. You can also change it to capture a specific window. And on here, what we can do is you can select a window that we want to capture. Like for example, I have Roblox open. I can just select that and click on OK, for example. But let's go back to capture any full screen application. Now, what you want to do is you want to open up a game. It doesn't really matter which game that you open up. I just opened up a really simple game that's Roblox, and I'm going to open it up. So let me open the game up. Click on open. And now it's going to show on here. Like you see, guys. But if there is a problem and it doesn't show up, there's exactly one issue. It's not full screen. So what you have to do is on your game settings, let's click on ready. On your game settings, or let's just press on escape so we can get there quickly. Go to here, your settings, go to your graphics settings. It doesn't really matter which game that you're playing. You want to make sure that every game, it doesn't matter, needs to be activated on full screen. If it's not activated on full screen, guys, it's not gonna detect our game. So that's the number one reason why you always want to get full screen on. So once you did it, guys, you are basically done. and now you can just start recording. Click on OK and you're done. So let's do that like that, really easy. And using a game capture card is a lot better than display because of the frame rates and stuff like that, the FPS. So let me close off the settings like that. And now you can just play without any problem at all and stuff like that. So that's how easy it actually is. And this is how you can fix the problem, guys, how to fix the detecting problem if it doesn't detect with your OBS Studios and stuff like that. So I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. This was basically it. If you did, you can just drop a like and subscribe. Also, you can leave a comment down below if you have further questions or if it worked out for you or stuff like that. And you can follow me at Twitter and Instagram. And it will really help me out if you could subscribe and like, actually. So take care and goodbye.